welcome back. So are you better off today than you were last year under President Trump? The White House says you are. This according to a year-end memo obtained by Axios. The Biden administration is sending this letter to Democrat lawmakers and supporters. And it reads this in part. In spite of unprecedented crises and opposition from congressional Republicans, President Biden, Vice President Harris, and congressional Democrats got an enormous amount done for the American people in 2021. There was also no mention of issues like the recent increase in the number of COVID cases, the botched-up Afghanistan withdrawal, which caused 13 service members to lose their lives, or soaring inflation. But does the claim that they do claim that they fixed the supply chain issues? And we've heard them say they've saved Christmas by doing so. Joining me right now is House Ways and Means Committee ranking member Kevin Brady. Congressman Brady, it's great to see you. Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you, Maria. Merry Christmas.
What do you make of this letter that the White House is sending to supporters that people are better off today than they were a year ago under President Trump?
Yeah, and what world are they living in? Truth of the matter is that they cited unprecedented crisis, by the way, the ones they created, whether it's in the border, on inflation, internationally, in the crime issue. Most Americans, by the way, feel they're worse off this year than last year, and their pessimism going forward, whether you're a working family facing, you know, 40-year highs in prices, or you're a small business whose new survey shows they are as pessimistic about the next year as they've been in 48 years. The truth of the matter is Americans have really lost any confidence that this president, frankly, has is competent to lead this country and heal the economy.
Yeah, it's a very hard argument to make, particularly as we watch these Fox Business polls show an increasing number of people are disapproving of this president's performance. We still don't know what Kamala Harris has been doing either.
Yeah, we don't. What we do know is that she hasn't bothered to do anything as a president on the border. We saw, you know, 100,000 some encounters in November on the border. We're seeing in cities like Houston record levels of homicides, as we've seen around the country. Certainly on the economic front, this president bungled, you know, very strong economy he inherited from President Trump. And what you've seen both in inflation and this labor crisis, labor shortage, frankly, these are President Biden's policies driving all of this.
Yeah, it's incredible. Let's talk about the year ahead, because Joe Biden says he hasn't given up on the Build Back Better plan. Progressives are now putting pressure on Biden to act on his own, to push through this far-left agenda using executive action. Do you think this is what is going to materialize in the year ahead? And walk us through what kind of hefty tax increases Americans may face should they get this through.
Yeah, I think this really worries me, Marie. I know there's a lot of discussion about the spending side of this, and Jill Manson is rightly worried about this real, truly $5 trillion cost of the bill, what it does to inflation, some of the far-left policies that shouldn't become law. He's rightly focused on that, but I'm focused, too, on the tax increases and on the provisions that make the labor shortage worse. Certainly, when you add $1.2 trillion of tax hikes on America's job creators and do it in a way where you drive U.S. jobs overseas, where you discourage investment here in the United States, where you hammer small businesses with about $400 billion of tax hikes, all as we're trying to recover from this pandemic economy. It just makes no economic sense at all. And they've got a couple provisions in there, Maria, that will make the labor shortage worse, including the child tax credit, which is no longer tethered to earnings or work. Experts, this is the first time this has happened. Experts predict it could drive 1.5 million workers to exit the workforce. And they have, of course, this new toddler tax where their child care area, their provisions in Build Back Better will double the price of child care, but only subsidize a few. So an average family with two kids in child care could pay an extra $27,000 a year. That, wow, too, will discourage people from reconnecting to work.
So, in other words, this is going to lead to more people wanting to stay off the job. Congressman, nobody knows policy like you. You wrote the tax cuts of 2017. And as a result of those tax cuts, we actually saw the bottom earners see the biggest wage increases over everybody. So what can you tell us about the likelihood that they're going to be able to get this through in some form in the new year?
Yeah, so at the end of the day, this this bill is as alive or dead as Senator Joe Manchin makes it to be. The question is, are they listening to what he's saying, and will they respond to it? If they do, they face another obstacle, which is, will progressives, you know, accept this? The truth of the matter is, their obstacle isn't Joe Manchin. Their obstacle is their extreme socialist agenda that America is not buying, and Joe Manchin isn't buying. And so I think they face several big barriers here in the new year. And frankly, every month this lingers, I think the better shot we have of defeating it.
Congressman, real quick, what do you think the motivation for all of this is? Socialism, wide open borders, 600,000 gotaways, inflation at a 40-year high. What's the motivation? Why push this down people's throats?
Well, part of it is incompetence. Frankly, the president doesn't, and the administration doesn't understand the economy, doesn't understand tax code. This is sort of a replay of Obama-Biden, where they bungled that economy as well. On open borders, clearly they think this helps them politically to pursue this. But as we know in Texas here, as we see, you know, as Hispanic working families turn against Democrats because of these policies, I think it'll hurt them even more. But I think bottom line is, this is about control. You know, Democrats in Washington right now, especially led by the president and Nancy Pelosi, want to have control of every moment of your life, from cradle to grave. They think the government, you know, can do this better than you, and all these policies reflect it.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.